In this video, I'm going to show you the dorsiflexion external rotation stress test to diagnose syndesmosis injuries. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Early and accurate diagnosis of ankle syndesmosis injury is essential to facilitate timely, effective and safe treatment, but they are difficult to diagnose. The incidence in ankle sprains ranges between 1 and 24%. The ankle syndesmosis includes the interosseous membrane and interosseous ligament, together with the anterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament, and transverse ligament. A recent systematic review showed that the external rotation stress test, as used by Boehm et al. From the year 2002, had very low overall diagnostic accuracy and low sensitivity. However, the test was performed without dorsiflexion. Dorsiflexion produces a slight widening of the ankle mortise, thereby stressing the syndesmosis, and should therefore be integral to test performance. The dorsiflexion external rotation stress test reproduces the mechanism of injury to the syndesmosis. According to a study by Sman et al. In the year 2013, it has a sensitivity of 71% and a specificity of 63%, and its clinical use as a standalone test is therefore rather weak. To perform the test, have your patient in sitting position with his knee hanging from the table in 90 degrees. Then bring the patient's talocrural joint into maximal dorsiflexion and apply an external rotation stress to the injured foot and ankle. This test is positive if the patient's anterolateral pain over the syndesmosis is reproduced. Alright, this was our video on the external rotation stress test. If you are curious about a more specific test for syndesmosis injuries, watch our video on the squeeze test right next to me. If you like this video, please click on the like button, subscribe to our channel if you haven't, and support our channel if you like our content. You can find various options in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye.